Now for our What in the World segment. There's perhaps no greater icon of American ingenuity than the Hoover Dam. A stunning mass of cement and rebar, its construction became an emblem of New Deal rebirth. The energy produced there drove the West's great cities into modernity. Now, a fascinating New York Times story reveals a new plan for the dam that could be just as revolutionary. Engineers with the Los Angeles Department of Water and Power want to turn it into what the Times called a giant battery. In other words, a place not just to generate, but to store renewable energy. Here's how it would work. They'd built a pump station as far as 20 miles downstream from the dam, powered by the solar and wind farms that now pepper the American West. That pump would drive water upstream to Lake Mead, the dam's massive reservoir, where it would eventually feed into the dam to be turned into energy again when needed. This is what's known as pumped storage, and it is an impressive feat of alchemy, spinning solar and wind into hydroelectric power. It also solves a very real problem. We're clearly in the midst of a renewable energy revolution. The first phase was about generation, harnessing the awesome power of the sun and the wind. There's been lots of progress on that front as cheap Chinese solar panels have flooded global markets. Solar power generation increased by more than 25,000% from 2000 to 2015. Wind generation grew by more than 2,500%. That's good news in terms of limiting dependence on fossil fuels, but now we need storage. Solar and wind are so-called intermittent sources. That means they're here one minute, gone the next. And as they scale up, they start causing problems. Take California, which leads the nation in solar capacity. In the middle of the day, when the sun is shining, solar floods the electricity grid, but then disappears at night when people need electric power most. Sometimes the state simply shuts down solar panels during the day to avoid overloading the grid. So more isn't always better unless you have storage, which is the next phase of the energy revolution. In Taming the Sun, a fascinating new book that tackles these issues, the author Varun Sivaram reveals a startling statistic. If the United States turned off all its sources of electricity immediately, it currently has enough storage capacity to power the country for just 43 minutes. So storage has a long way to go, but many smart people have very big ideas for what to do about it. Last year, Elon Musk made the world's largest lithium-ion battery to store the energy from a sprawling wind farm in southern Australia. The battery is agile, responding to outages in a fraction of a second, and it can store up to 129 megawatt hours of wind energy. That is still a drop in the bucket of the country's demand, but it's a start. Here's another wild idea, solar fuels. Scientists are working on technology that would use the sun's rays to split a molecule of water into its component parts and funnel the hydrogen for fuel. And fuel is a much easier way to store energy than batteries. Bill Gates is funding some of the research, noting that 1 ton of gasoline contains the same amount of energy as 60 tons of batteries. These ideas might sound overly ambitious, but so did building the Hoover Dam 90 years ago.